Commissioners Court. Today is Tuesday, March 12th, 2019. It is 10 a.m. Commissioner Kirkendall will be absent today, but all of the members of the court are present, and this meeting is called to order. If everyone will please rise for the invocation by Commissioner Cooper, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.
Dear Lord, we ask you to be with us today as we go about the business of the county. We ask you to help us make the right decisions concerning our citizens. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Yes, sir.
Item number three, approve minutes of the February 26, 2019 regular meeting as presented by Glenda Austin.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Roberts and a second by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number four, approve amended minutes of the June 19, 2018 regular meeting as presented. This was a item that Angela had caught during an audit, and the amendments were approved. I think Laura emailed that out to everybody last week.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Roberts and a second by Commissioner Pelt. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number five, cancel all registered claims from the February 26, 2019 regular meeting as requested and approval of cash statement as presented by Deborah McWilliams, County Treasurer. Good morning, Ms. McWilliams.
Good morning. I'm asking the court to release me of the liability of $1,497,034.18.
Thank you, ma'am. And the cash statement?
The cash statement and general checking, we have $1,944,009.65. In our investment account, $2,151,569.57. In text pool, $13,751,719.15 for a total cash funds of $17,847,298.37. Also, this report includes from text pool, the interest earned in February was $22,885.71.
Move approve item five.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Pelt and a second by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Thank you very much. Item number six, authorization to pay county bills as presented by Ms. Angela Gore, County Auditor. Good morning, Ms. Gore.
Good morning. Our expenditures for Commissioner's Court today are $190,169.56. Attached is a list of additional bills in the amount of $80,325.48. The total expenditures and transfers are $270,495.04. The gross payroll for March the 14th is $457,615.60, and the total transfers for that payroll is $557,530.28.
Move to pay the county bill.
Second. I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper and a second by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number seven, request approval of fiscal year 2018 budget amendments. Angela Gore.
At this time, we'd like to request the following amendments. In the general fund, we would like to increase the revenue in miscellaneous reimbursement by $18,000. And increase the expenditures and election expenses, miscellaneous expenses by $18,000. Increase revenue under miscellaneous reimbursement by $17,000 and increase the expenditures in Commissioner's Court under the capital murder trials by $17,000. In the DA's office, we'd like to transfer expenses from the outside service appeals by $640 and transfer those expenditures to the district attorney salaries, the temporary position. In the health department, in the general fund, we had a expense to transfer to the wireless phone data for $38 and from the office supplies for that amount. In the jury fund, the expenditures to the county jury pauper attorney CPS by $500 and that expense is coming from the county jury pauper attorney adult by $500. And also in the jury fund, the CPS court jury, the CPS pauper attorney, $10,000 is going to that account from the account of the 88th court jury petty jury by $10,000. Budget transfers for the general fund expenditures to the autopsy line item by in the amount of $17,250 from the miscellaneous expense line item. Going to fuel and oil in the sheriff's department, $20,000 is coming from the health insurance by $14,000 and also the outside service by $6,000. In the jail department, we have expenditures going to the prisoner medical by $15,242, the prisoner food by $8,445, and that's coming from the health insurance in a total of $23,687. And in indigent, we need to transfer to our physician services in the amount of $15,391 to the UTMB contract by $26,700, and that's coming from the indigent hospital inpatient line item by $42,091.
We'll approve the budget amendments and transfers.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Pelt and a second by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number 8, consider request for approval to accept a donation from West Rock Corporation in the amount of $10,000. This is a request by Sheriff Davis, and if approved, amend the budget as follows. Increase the revenue, line item 01036710 4, titled Donations Sheriff's Department, in the amount of $10,000, and increase expenditures in the line item 01056039 4, titled Donated Funds Equipment, in the same amount, $10,000.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper and a second by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Sheriff, did you have anything you want to say about that?
Just the intended purpose of that donation. It's a community grant that they do just to replace the technology protocol. We've got laptops in there that are about 10 years old. And of course, you imagine they were bumping potholes and other yards in, and they're just wore out. So that's kind of helping us get a good look at some technology.
Sounds good. Y'all been kind of busy the last few days.
Yes, we have.
Y'all are in our prayers, you and your men and women and the victims involved.
Thank
you. Yes, sir. Item number 9, consider adoption of Resolution 10-19, recognizing March 21st, 2019 as a day honoring the Harvest Call volunteer team serving Hardin County.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper and a second by Commissioner Pelt. Just to make sure everybody knows, this Harvest Call team has been here since about the last week of December. They'll be here through roughly the end of March. They're helping at least 20 families move back into their homes. 6 of those families will receive brand new homes, and the others are being remodeled, and that's from the Harvey disaster. So I think I saw Michelle walk in. That's a partnership that Michelle made with Harvest Call through Harvey County Strong and also through iConnect Outreach, who's been here since about 3 weeks after the storm. And those families are very fortunate to receive this benefit. And I'll present this resolution to Harvest Call on March the 21st. And I think that's at 6:30 p.m., is that right?
Yes, sir.
All right, any other discussion? All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number 10, is anybody here from Harvest Call? Okay, I think they're all working, right?
They were just here, they couldn't stay for the meeting.
Okay, thank you. Number 10, acceptance of Hardin County Emergency Services District Number 4, audited financial statements for the year ending September 30th, 2018. Ms. Gore, have you had an opportunity to review that statement?
I have.
And everything's in order?
Yes, sir.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Pelt and a second by Commissioner Roberts to accept the financial statement. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Number 11, discussion and possible action to approve and accept the final plat of Deer Creek Run subdivision located in Precinct 2, and that's going to be presented by Amanda Young, Floodplain Administrator. Good morning.
Good morning. This is actually an exempt subdivision. All of the tracts will be more than 10 acres, and they all front on County Road or State Highway. They just wanted
Commissioner Pelton, a second by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item number 12, discussion and possible action on recommendation from the Evaluation Committee concerning proposals received for a vendor to occupy and operate the courthouse cafe. Misty Sims, good morning.
March 5th, 2019, Ronald and Robin Doucette submitted a proposal to occupy and operate the courthouse cafe. We didn't have a minimum lease fee per month stated in our request for proposal, and they are asking if we would consider waiving the monthly fee for a period of time to allow them to get established. The Evaluation Committee was Linda Kellum, Amanda Young, and Debbie Mendesabel. Debbie was out due to illness in the family, but Linda and Amanda are both agreeable and are recommending that we give them a chance at the cafe.
All right.
Accept the proposal and approve it.
I have a motion by Commissioner Pelton, a second by Commissioner Roberts. What is the monthly lease amount that they've included in their proposal?
They actually did not include any. I think they were hoping to have it waived for 6 months or something like that and then start it up. And the Doucettes are actually here. They'd like to address the court if possible.
Okay. So after the, if we waive it for a period of time, are they going to start paying an amount of rent or? Do we know what that amount is? Did they include that in their proposal?
We were going to negotiate it with the contract. We can discuss that, I guess.
Okay.
And then we'd have to bring it back to court to get it approved.
I would say that we definitely need somebody out there, and it would be great if y'all come. I would be against waiving the fee simply because the people we had in there before paid a fee, and it wouldn't be right to them. We need y'all there. I would be in very much agreeance to dropping that fee to $1 or $10 for the amount of time. But we have to say there's a fee because we charge the other people a fee. That's just my opinion. So I don't know how the other members of the court feel about that. But, I mean, they might go for none. But.
I'll change my motion to a fee of $10 a month for 6 months.
And then after 6 months, we'll renegotiate that? Okay. All right, so that's part of Commissioner Pelt's motion. Is that part of your second as well, Commissioner Roberts? Anything else, Misty?
Yes, sir.
All right, and did y'all have something y'all wanted to say?
I just want to introduce ourselves. I'm Robin, and this is Ronnie,
our
BG and Papa.
All right.
We have 9 kids, 15 grandkids, we live in Lumberton.
Okay.
And we just wanted to be a service to you guys. I know it was kind of a need, and we've spoken to a few of the employees, and so we wanted to come in and help you guys and ourselves as well. It would be an honor to be able to do it. So.
Cook good food?
He does. I'm a baker, he's a cooker, and I was also a barista. So eventually we'd like to have kind of a cool little coffee bar and everything in there. So.
Okay. Sounds good.
We appreciate it.
Thank you all very much. We look forward to it. All right, any other discussion on this item? All in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Y'all gonna start cooking breakfast in the morning?
Yes, we'll have breakfast and lunch.
Tomorrow morning though, right?
Not tomorrow. Yeah, April.
We'll push it by April 1st.
Sounds good.
Or whatever that first Monday.
I just need to know so I can cut the other person off.
All right, sounds good. All right, item number 13, discussion and possible action on recommendation from Evaluation Committee concerning proposals received for a shoe sign vendor to install and operate a booth concession in the courthouse. Ms. Sims?
Proposals were received on February 22nd, 2019 at 2 p.m. in the Purchasing Department front office. Myself, Stacy Eckert, and Erica Singletary were present. The Evaluation Committee for this was Commissioner Cooper, Judge Brewer, and Dennis Allen. They met last week and are recommending that we move forward with putting a shoe shine vendor in here. And it's Spurs Boot Shine with Mrs. Riggs, and she's here.
She's here?
Yes.
All right, good morning.
Good morning.
I move to approve the recommendation made by the Evaluation Committee.
Second.
A second by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Welcome to Hardin County. When will y'all get started, do you think?
April 1st.
April 1st. All right, we can eat and get our boots shined.
There you go, first.
Thank y'all very much.
Thank you.
14, results in awarding of bids received for generators for all road and bridge precincts utilizing funds received from the Texas Department of State Health Services Hurricane Crisis Response Grant. Ms. Sims?
Bids were opened on February 28, 2019 at 2 p.m. in the Purchasing Department front office. Myself, Stacy Eckert, and Greg Bailey were present. We received 6 bids. FNT Construction was $69,419.20. A&A Electric, $84,057. Gulf Coast Electric, $172,800. All Pro Electrical was $66,857. Electrical Specialties at $57,375. Biscamp Electric at $44,300, with Biscamp being the apparent low.
And they all bid by the same specifications?
Yes, sir.
I move we accept the low bid.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Pelt and a second by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion on this item? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Thank you, Ms. Sims. Item number 15, setting of workshop to receive and consider information from council for the Hardin-Jefferson ISD and Beaumont ISD regarding the bond debt and property of Beaumont ISD that must be allocated between Hardin-Jefferson ISD and Beaumont ISD by Hardin and Jefferson counties as a result of the annexation and detachment of the territory known as Bevel Oaks. And we're looking to set that for March 25th at 1:30 p.m. Is that good for everybody? I've already heard from Commissioner Kirkendall that it's not good for him, but he's okay if we go forward without him. Is that good with everybody else?
Yes.
So we'll set that workshop for 1:30 p.m. on March 25th. Both council will be at the Jefferson County Commissioner's Court that morning at 10:30 a.m. if anybody would like to go listen in on that. I've got a probate docket that morning and can't be there, but if y'all wanted to get a heads up on what we'll hear at 1:30, y'all welcome to go sit in. Judge Brannick has invited us to do that.
Good.
So that is set, and we'll move on to item number 16, discussion only of any other item that's not on the agenda without taking any action by any county official. Commissioner Cooper, do you want to remind everybody one more time about tomorrow?
Yes, a reminder, tomorrow is the luncheon for retired elected officials as well as current elected officials, and that'll be at the annex across the street at 11:30.
And you're cooking, right?
I'm having somebody cook.
As long as it's good, that's all that matters. All right. Any of the commissioners have any items? Ms. Gore? Ms. Austin?
Who would adjourn?
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Pelt and a second by Commissioner Cooper. All in favor?
Aye.